Okay, so cottaging may be a great Canadian pastime, but one Ontario hotspot has gone all Hollywood. Mark Wahlberg, David Beckham, and his wife is in there, and all the kids, they've all been partying in Muskoka. And Billy, you're heading that way too, so what is it about Muskoka that is attracting our neighbors to the south, the famous ones?
I have one thing to say. Build that wall.
Build
that wall. You need to keep Americans and Hollywood away from my Muskoka.
This precious.
I've been going there for 10 years. No, I mean, you know, when I'm up there, you know, island hopping, I pull up to Cindy and Randy's dock for a quick custom.
That's Migos. Cindy Crawford, by the way.
Yeah.
And that is truthful that you do.
Every year, yeah. Touch me. I know Cindy. Listen, let me tell you something. This is hard for me to say this. This is very easy for me to say this, but it's sad for me to say this. America's such a mess right now,
mm-hmm.
with, you know, violence and division and craziness with politics, economic uncertainty, which we have here. But it's like America with Hollywood and the military, they like flex like they're all that. This country is the most beautiful, the most civilized, and the best quality of life, not in North America, in like the world. It's one of the greatest places in the world. I am not lying. And if you live within 100 miles of the border and it's not the winter. no, but if it's just the gem that you have up in Muskoka, it's so beautiful. For those of you that I'm assuming most of you know, but there's three lakes, Rosso, Muskoka, and Joe. They're all dotted with these like 2 to 5, 6, 7 acre islands. Many of the, you know, Canadian sort of robber barons back in the day built these mansions on these lakes. They've all been refurbished. And, you know, I think Danny Aykroyd's had a place up there, maybe Martin Short.
Yeah.
I know John Candy used to have a place up mm-hmm. there. Kurt and Goldie used to have a place up there. Cindy and Randy. And I can't afford it, so I mooch off of them.
I put
up a tent on their dock. I'm not even allowed in the house.
You know what's my favorite thing to almost do up there, though? Like, you know how in Hollywood you can do the tour of the stars' homes?
Yeah.
In Muskoka, because I've been going there since I was very young as well, but you go and you rent for, like, whatever you can afford, if you can afford anything at all, even just to rent. And you go out and you rent a pontoon or you get a boat for the day, and I go up there all the time. You guys know Erica Wark. We're up there all the time.
Right.
And you get your boat and you literally just go and you kind of, like, have your phone out and you literally hop on your boat. That's us. And you just go and you just gawk at the other half, because these are 14, 15, $20 million mansions.
No question.
And you go to Billionaire's Row on Lake Joe, you go to Millionaire's Row on Lake Muskoka, and you just go, who lives here?
Yeah,
and then you try to spot them.
Yeah.
And then you yell at them from your boat because you're, you know, you're not fancy.
But it's so cool,
you know?
You can go from dock to dock to dock on your boat. You can go to, like, Kenny G's house, and you go to Harry Hamlin's house.
I mean, we're not doing
Cindy's
that.
whatever your version of that is, yeah.
Kenny G. I have this vision of him. Like, I would love to see him. I'm going up there next week. Can you just imagine Kenny G, that sweet sound of that sax against the song of the loons?
Beautiful.
That is a beautiful thing.
He would be
thing.
At your perfect
but
cottage
I want you to
weekend.
Keep,
yes.
I want you to keep something in perspective. It's never going to get... Let's try to keep it... Let's build the wall to try and keep it from getting so out of control. Because the reason I summer in Skinny Atlas in the Finger Lakes in New York, from Syracuse to all the way out to mm-hmm. the Ohio border. There's 11 lakes, and they're spectacular. A little bit different because the one I'm on is 16, 17 miles long, and it's like a mile wide. Fingers. And but, you know, when you're in the Hamptons, and you know how that drive up there could either be 2 hours or 5 hours. Same thing with the Hamptons. But when you're like going to get your morning coffee and paper, and it should take 10 minutes, and it takes an hour and a half, and then you're standing in line to get a croissant, and you're seeing all the people that you left the city to try and escape from, and they're all talking about whether you got invited to P. Diddy's white party or not, you know, and like that level of obnoxious pretentiousness,
we don't want that.
Well, that's why when I come here, I'm like, oh, it's so cute here in Muskoka. Torontonians, they say it's so, like, it's like getting obnoxious up there. No, go to the Hamptons, and that'll put
obnoxious.
Everything in perspective for
you're,
you, okay?
Billy, you're going to be up there this weekend because there is an amazing event that is taking place. It is back for the first time since this pandemic broke out. It is the Boat Rally for Cancer. All proceeds this year are benefiting Sunnybrook Health Sciences Center and Ronald McDonald House Charities. So tell us, what is this event in Muskoka? What is this?
Well, I've done the event. Here's what I love about it. It's just like super, super outside of the box, dynamic, very hip scavenger hunt. And you get on the boat, you get in these like 1930s Chris Crafts.
Wow.
And we do all sorts of fun events like that. We go from island to island with clues, and we're trying to bring, and you'll see here, this is just incredible. But you know, we've all been on the rubber chicken circuit where you go to another hotel for another event, they introduce an award winner, the award winner gives their speech, as soon as the last award is given and the band plays, everyone like boom, yeah, calls for the exits because there's another one tomorrow night. And it's just so cool to be raising money for such an important cause, mm-hmm, but having so much fun. It's not another golf round of golf. It's not another speech at another hotel with a chicken dinner. Mm-hmm. By the way, Mademoiselle is catering it.
Oh, yes, very nice.
And also, just a shout out quickly, Joel Hawk, Solutions with Impact. He produces this every year, amazing. And our two lead sponsors, Sean Jalili from Platinum Cars, and of course, Steve Meehan, he's from Glen Road Capital Partners. Those guys are the ones that put up the money to underwrite this. And we couldn't do it if it wasn't for their generosity and mm-hmm, it wasn't for their support. And we raise, I think through Solutions with Impact, they've raised like $25, $26 million.
Wow. That's incredible.
Well, Billy, have a blast. Have a blast in Muskoka this weekend. Say hi to all your famous friends for the girls from the social.
Cindy and Randy. Yes,
yes. And tell them to come here.
Cindy and Randy. We want to tell everybody watching, it is boatrallyforkids.ca if you want to find out more about all the amazing work that they're doing.
You know where you can get some more all-around great content? Our YouTube page. It's filled with all the laughs and thought-provoking chats you could ask for. So do yourself a favor, like and subscribe now.